It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. It's basketball out in Brooklyn. Barclays Center is the venue. We'll see the Nets go up against the New York Knicks. Checking out New York, the wheels have started to come off for them recently. Clearly a mid-season swoon taking place. We'll see if they can start to shake out of it tonight. And a chance in this one to get a look at the NBA's leading scorer. Freak has just been incredible so far this season. Just defies description. Do you see him holding onto the scoring title this year, Kenny?
Well, a big thing for Freak is trying to avoid the stat-chasing thing.
This is 2K Sports broadcasting from Brooklyn, New York, as the Nets take it to the hardwood here at the Barclays Center. We welcome you this Thursday evening as we get set for some exciting NBA action on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan joining me, Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and courtside Doris Burke. And, of course, Jose Calderon. We'll see how they continue to fare without him.
You know, what the trade means to me, guys, is they think some of their younger players are ready to spread their wings and take on a little more responsibility. They're going to get more minutes for those guys and allow them to see a little more playing time.
Clearly a forward-thinking deal, you know, and even if his aren't the biggest shoes to fill, it still puts a lot of pressure on your young guys. And let's see if they're ready to fill that void.
Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. And New York, looking at who they've got. Porzingis is out there with Anthony. Then there's DJ Augustine. Then there's Robin Lopez. And it's Aflalo in at the shooting guard position. It's another look. And so he earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
Yeah, really left him no choice there, Greg. I mean, he had to foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
He makes one of two that time. Now the Knicks with it, fresh from a win against the Nuggets.
They were just locked, really in a zone from a team defense standpoint, and nobody ever got stuck on an island. There was always somebody providing help, and the communication was tremendous.
And that was the key, Greg, communication and the teamwork. You can't play good rotating defense if you're not communicating and on the same page. They were doing all of that at a high level.
Now here's Evans. A 35-point game for him in the win against Orlando.
But his passing just blew me away. I mean, to see him operate their offense that way was a breath of fresh air.
Here is Augustine. He had 13 points in the win against Denver.
And also, his assist total tells you about the job he did of keeping his head up and keeping his teammates involved.
A chance now to go to Doris Burke, who had a chance to visit with Kurt Rambis.
Kevin, when I asked him about their game plan on the defensive end, he said they were looking to clog things up in the middle of the floor and not allow any clear looks at the basket from inside the paint. He feels if they can accomplish that, they'll have the upper hand on defense. Let's see how it plays out, Kevin.
Thanks again, Doris. Here's Anthony following the bucket by the Nets. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. The Knicks shooting their initial free throws of the game right here.
And collectively, they're only about 73% as a unit right now.
And, you know, you don't have to tell them what their free throw numbers are. I mean, they're well aware of it, believe me.
The first quarter of action, 2 minutes in. Jack with it in the game against Orlando. Very impressive. Kicks it out to Johnson. Takes a three. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Nets. That one was played in Brooklyn.
Yeah, not a very inspired performance for them, particularly when they were defending. They just gave that hostile crowd plenty to cheer for.
Yeah, they allowed a lot of free runs to the hoop, a lot of open jump shots. And in the end, the opponent's shooting percentage was through the roof. You can't win if your defense isn't better than that.
Now here's Aflalo. Following the miss by Freak, Anthony, no one around, and good. coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense if he's got the A game rolling tonight.
And Jack, here we go, Lopez, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
The Knicks leading by four, and Augustine kicks to a follow. New York moving it around. Lopez, a screen on Evans. Lopez, a screen. Here's Anthony. The shot no good. And Brooklyn will now go the other way with it. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
And I believe what that game came down to was their ability to really knock down those triples.
Yeah, I thought the work they did on the perimeter was excellent. It was just too much for that defense, or really any defense for that matter, to handle.
Here's Augustine after Joe Johnson's score. Lopez a screen. Here's Anthony. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
And no excuse there for missing that one after being freed up by a great pick.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, they came away empty, but they got the look they wanted. And really, I like the movement and communication there.
And it's the Knicks with the ball after Joe Johnson's score. Lopez a screen. Here's a follow. Porzingis passes to a follow. Over Thornton. Takes the 12-footer and hits. Aflalo's got his second bucket of the night.
There you go again. A nice kick out after the D had collapsed on it.
Evans, a screen on Augustine. And Jack, here we go. From 12 feet out. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. 7 points for Joe Johnson.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
And Aflalo kicks to Augustine. Outside Anthony, shoots from the line, and it's Anthony again missing. Nets have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Thornton dishes to Johnson, and it's Johnson again missing. A follow, the pass to Augustine. Pass to Porzingis. And a follow wide open. He shoots. And again, New York with the triple.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Here's Johnson. And they cash in right away with a quick shot. Johnson's got 9.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Lopez a screen. The drive by Anthony uses the glass that time, and it's good. 9 points in the game so far.
He presents a defender with a serious challenge, always.
To the paint. Here's Evans. Good, and Jack gets the assist.
An excellent display of passing out there, fellas. I mean, 8 of their last 10 points have been assisted on.
And they just keep finding the open man.
Shot off the pick. Here's Porzingis, and there's another one for the Knicks.
Just a major size difference between the defender and shooter on that possession.
And Greg, without a hand in his face, he's simply going to spray whoever's there.
All right now, I want everyone here at the Barclays Center.
And with this break, why don't we check out the hottest shooting point guards over the last month. Jared Jackson.
Some remarkable shooters in that group. I mean, you know that when you're seeing those types of numbers at the point guard position, you're talking about some very intelligent and patient players.
In addition to being unbelievably gifted shooters, I mean, these guys have some of the smoothest, sweetest strokes in the NBA, which means they have some of the best strokes in the world.
Rivers can't get it to go.
Oh, man, you know he'd love to have that one over.
Evans kicks to Bargnani. Stolen away. To the inside. Here's Anthony. That one off the back iron and out.
Rebounding's going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
No, it always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
Boy, I love the great assist that time by Jack.
And so it's New York with it. After the basket by Brooklyn. Now here's Rivers. looking for his first basket still in this one. And here is Jack in the corner. It's Galloway. Good, and Jack gets the assist. Jack's got his sixth assist on the night.
These defenders look overmatched right now, especially inside.
Well, they've given up 10 of the last 12 points from close range, so I'd have to agree with you, Barton.
Kicks it to Aflalo. Takes the three. Nice. 4 for 7 from the floor with that shot.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
Jack dishes to Evans. The kick out to Jack. Back to Evans. Young outside. Launches it. And he gets it to go. Young's got his second bucket tonight.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
The Nets with the lead. Outside Jack. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Got a piece of it. And now the Knicks on the break. Here's Rivers. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And taking a look now at stats for Evans. He's been on a remarkable tear this past month. How about 44 points per and 13 assists? And not many players possess his kind of ability to protect the rim. I mean, you look at the block total, pretty remarkable.
Yeah, you know, we've seen drivers think they see a crease in the defense and then go for it. And then he shuts the door on them right away.
The Nets making a switch here. Hollis Jefferson's checked in. The Knicks also changing it up. Williams comes in for Porzingis. And it's Caldwell Pope in for Aaron Aflalo. There's Galloway. He's guarded by Rivers. Galloway kicks to Evans. Young, right side. Again, Young missing.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
And really, just a lack of awareness on his part. Just no idea he was right near the line.
Galloway kicks to Evans. Picked by Bargnani. The feed to Galloway. Back to Evans. And stolen by Williams. Here's Caldwell Pope. Hammers it home to polish off the break.
And guys, got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
That's exactly the way to do it, too, Kevin. Go hard to the bucket, and don't let them set up the defense.
Now here's Evans. Oh, yes, the turnaround. Evans has got his second basket.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
It really is. 5 out of 6 of their last field goals have come from the paint. And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
1:57 left to play in the first quarter. There's a good screen. Thaddeus Young on the wing. That's miss number 3 for him. Now 2 for 5 from the floor. And pushing it up, here's New York. And the rejection by Evans. Here's Galloway, covered by Anthony. Williams against Evans. Here's Galloway. The basket good off the assist from Evans. Evans has got 3 assists now in this one.
A wide open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
Rivers kicks to Caldwell Pope. Anthony against Young. Outside Williams. Fires the 3. That shot by Caldwell Pope, no good. Brooklyn's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Evans outside. They double him with Rivers. Here's Bargnani. Another shot. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A 3-point play chance here. Tyler Hansbrough's checked in for the Nets. For Brooklyn, they have converted 1 of 2 free throws so far today. Knicks trail by 3. 40 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Williams can't hit. It's the Nets now. Pass to Young, taken away by Anthony. Rivers with him. He's against Young. Rivers can't get it to go.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint.
Evans, a screen on Rivers. Galloway, the pass to Evans. And he slams it one-handed.
Tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered the backboard.
Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. Nets lead by 5. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Brooklyn. And a chance to hear from former number 2 overall pick Derek Williams about his focus offensively.
Just getting to the basket more, you know, being able to take
him back. Two huge improvements for him. The Knicks also changing it up. Serafin comes in for Robin Lopez, and Carmelo Anthony subbed in for Augustine. And New York, looking at who they got. We've got Rivers. Kevin Serafin is out there with Williams. Then it's Anthony, and it's Caldwell Pope in at the 2 spot.
Well, a lot of tough teams in this league. Here's where Brooklyn sits right now. First in scoring, first in assists. And they're also number 1 in shooting percentage. This is a team that prides itself on taking high-quality shots.
And you go back to their offense, the most explosive in the league. I mean, everyone talks about the great offense beating great defenses. And I tell you what, they make it difficult to hang with them.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak, in the last matchup against the Magic, delivered quite a performance. He had 35 points, and that was just the start of it, notching a triple-double for his effort in what was quite a display from him. Numbers like that are rare to see by any player in a game he'll always remember.
Great job, Doris. Thank you, guys. It's going to be very interesting to see if he can stay in a role like that tonight.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes those hot streaks can last for days, and I'm sure they'll be feeding him the basketball, hoping he's still got that mojo working.
Well, they ought to. I mean, when you've got a thoroughbred like him, I think you've got to ride him for as long as he'll carry you.
Picked by Williams. Shoots off the screen, and the shot no good, a bit short. Brooklyn's gotten both of their 3-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter. Here's Galloway. He's guarded by Rivers. Galloway kicks to Evans. And that misses. That would have put him up.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Here's Anthony. Knocks down the step back Jay. Anthony's got 15 points.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Here's Galloway. He's guarded by Rivers. And Hansbrough kicks to Evans. Marvelous lead pass, and he throws it down.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Man, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
Rivers kicks to Caldwell Pope. A 3-pointer off the mark. Brooklyn's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Evans outside. He dishes it to Hansbrough. Stripped it away. And they're pushing it up. That shot by Caldwell Pope, no good.
You know, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far.
And it's Brooklyn scoring again.
The chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. Four straight field goals have been made off an assist.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the right.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that. He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Serafin takes a big height bounce and goes in. Serafin's got six here in this quarter.
I really like the fact that he's getting the touches he needs here after not scoring a single point in that first quarter.
There's a screen by Hansbrough. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Takes the 13-footer. At the top of the key, Galloway. The dish now to Hansbrough. Passes it to Galloway. To the middle. Tries again. Evans' shot is good. Evans has got the game tied up here for the Nets. 8 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Rivers kicks to Williams. A three-pointer, no good. Tie game in Brooklyn. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Rebounding certainly a big part of the contributions you've made early in this one. Do you think this game is going to come down to which team hustles the most?
Yeah, it's going to be, I think it's going to be about who wants it more. But we're playing with a passion right now. We'll hopefully, we'll stay driven the rest of the way in order to get this win.
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third.
Well, take a look at the numbers for Evans. He has 9 rebounds, and he hasn't forgotten to get his teammates involved either.
And he's conscious, I think, Clark, of good ball movement. It needs to be a part of their game plan throughout.
Evans in at power forward. Thornton out there with Jarrett Jack. Then it's Brook Lopez. And it's Johnson in at the three. So that's the Nets 5. The Nets shooting the 6th attempt at the free throw line tonight.
Yeah, looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
And guys, that's really an upgrade over how they shot last season. Not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless.
Nice shot by Porzingis.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
And it's one thing to get the steal, but to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, even better.
And a wide-open look for Thornton. And a great assist by Jack as that one goes in.
You know, looking around, he knew one of his teammates was going to be open when they hit him with that double team, and he took advantage.
They set the pick. Here's Augustine. Lopez with the block. But they'll get another chance. The open shot, Aflalo. And he gets it to go from the corner. Aflalo's got 14. Brooklyn's gone 5 of 8 from three-point land. 15 points and a deep ball for them tonight. Here's Jack. And it's Brooklyn scoring again.
That makes 3 in a row to start the second half.
Knicks trail by 4. And Augustine kicks to Anthony. Lopez sets a screen for Anthony. A rebound by the Nets. Evans has got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Here's Thornton. It falls for the 6th time in 7 tries this contest. That's 86%.
Well, it's been a great start for this offense here in the second half. 4 for 4.
Jack against Augustine. The pass to Porzingis. 17-foot shot on the way.
That's exactly how you have to defend him. He's a guy that the D needs to be aware of at all times.
Evans dishes to Jack. Jack gets a screen from Evans. And Jack, here we go. The second chance effort. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there.
Yeah, just nice strength there, and then just off with the shot.
Boy, with all the contact he drew there, Greg, that would have been a heck of a bucket. He nearly got it to go.
That one is no good.
Can't connect there, but still a red-hot start to the half, hitting four of their first five field goal attempts.
Shoots from 12. They get it back. It'll go, and the Nets lead is cut down now to just five on the basket from Porzingis.
And that put back about as easy a bucket as you're going to get.
Exactly what happens when you don't box out, Greg.
Moment now to see nice three-point percentage numbers on this list. A look at the leaderboard showing us the most accurate three-point shooting two men in the league. Fifth best, Marcus Thornton.
These guys are gunners. I mean, they've got the green light at all times because of their three-point shooting. I mean, they are cash money.
Well, when they're shooting the percentages they shoot, I mean, you never want to see these guys passing up an open look from beyond the arc. I mean, they're firmly in the let it fly zone. All systems go with them.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
And both free throws, good for Evans.
Out Carmelo Anthony. Tremendous numbers for him over the last 10 games. Third in scoring, and he's in the top 20 in assists per game. His talent for creating easy buckets for his teammates, such an asset.
You know, to do what he does, you have to have that scorer's mentality. I mean, he knows he's the go-to guy, and everybody else knows it too. He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
And Jack kicks to Evans. 13 feet away. Carmelo Anthony comes up with the rebound.
He's not necessarily a strong inside presence, but he needs to polish those chances off. Well, some really terrific numbers for Aflalo. He's got 14 points, and he's knocked down a pair of three-pointers in this game, too.
And maybe it's time for them to set a few more screens for him up top and let him add to that total.
And he's good on the second. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Evans, a screen on Augustine. And Jack, here we go. Excellent use of the screen that time. Jack's got his third basket of the night.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Anthony against Johnson. Took the opportunity when he saw it. 17 points for Carmelo Anthony.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
Anthony against Johnson. Evans outside. Down low, Lopez. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
How about that, breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more.
Yes, indeed.
A follow the pass to Carmelo. Takes a shot at the elbow. Again, the miss by Anthony. Nets leading by six. Here's Evans. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling. They're doing a great job here in the second half. They've brought their free throw percentage up quite a bit. And that's winning basketball. That's one of the ingredients in winning basketball. Good free throw shooting.
Bargnani has checked in for Brooklyn. It's stolen by Jack. Inside, they get a hand on it. It's stolen by Anthony. Dishes to Aflalo. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Anthony's got four assists now tonight.
Just too dominant in the low post to let him have the ball. in that close.
Yeah, really simple opportunity for him. I mean, that's his bread and butter there.
High arcing shot goes back up. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. Anthony's got 4 points now in the quarter. Nets leading by four. Here's Jack. He's got six. Here's Evans. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
Here's Augustine. From down in the low post, it goes. Augustine's got eight.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
The Nets have gone 7-9 from the field to start this second half. Some tremendous shooting from them. Jack dishes to Evans. Picked by Bargnani. Evans kicks to Bargnani. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. He's got six.
The screen play worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screen play you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Pass to Porzingis from outside the arc, and the shot is good. Porzingis has got 9 points now in just the second half.
He's really done a nice job taking advantage of his opportunities in this half.
Bargnani has screen on Augustine. Evans, right side. Shot by Jack. Wide open. Yes, and a nice assist from Evans. 9 points now for Jack.
There's been a change in this game compared to what we saw in the first half. I mean, he's scoring with a lot of confidence now.
The drive by Anthony. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Anthony's got 21 in the game.
Effective screen set there for the jump shot. That was the key to the play.
Jack passes to Evans. Feeds to Johnson. Off target from three-point range. Knicks trail by four. Now Augustine. 8 points for him. Here's Porzingis. And again, New York with the triple.
You know, what an advantage he brings to this offense, guys. I mean, being able to drain the three ball, that really can spread a defense and extend the defense as well.
Evans dishes to Jack. Johnson, wide open, he fires. And again, it's Brooklyn converting.
Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
And Augustine kicks to Anthony. Steps back and shoots. And too long on the shot.
Almost no chance of that shot going in.
Yeah, there were a lot of other places he could have gone with the basketball instead of forcing that shot up.
Evans kicks to Johnson. And it's Johnson again missing. Knicks trail by three. A follow, the pass to Augustine. Evans with it. 22 points for him. And he stops it. What a pass to set him up.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Could be. A dunk like that coming off a great defensive play has to build some momentum.
Augustine passes to Porzingis. All sorts of time. Bargnani grabs the board.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
Kicks to Evans. And stolen by Aflalo. And pushing it up. Here's New York. Aflalo's running. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
What a night for Augustine. He has 8 points. And what a game he's had passing the ball, too.
I love the fact that he plays for his teammates, really spreading the ball around, getting everyone involved.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets. Thomas Robinson, he's checked in for Bargnani. Young comes in for Johnson. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Marcus Thornton. And a new group in for the Knicks. Kevin Serafin is checked in for Lopez. Williams comes in for Porzingis. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for Anthony. And it's Austin Rivers in for Aaron Aflalo. Here's Serafin. New York, no good that time either. Nets leading by five. Evans outside. Outside Jack. Here's the three. Yes, and a nice assist from Evans. And 12 points for Jarrett Jack.
You know, it's really hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
It's a stark discrepancy when you look at the assist columns and you see that difference as far as the fluidity in their respective offenses. Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Yeah, they've had a great second half from long range, Greg. I mean, things are definitely starting to look up for them. Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. Terrible turnover.
Knicks trail by nine, and New York looking at who they've got. We've got Robin Lopez. Porzingis is out there with Anthony. Then there's Austin Rivers. And it's Aflalo in at the two guard. The Nets have gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. The feed to Jack. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. And that's Evans penetrating and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
You know, you've got to like the fact that they're getting to the line. And on top of that, they're making their free throws in this half. That bodes well going forward.
And let's take a moment, guys, to get your take on the scoring so far for the Nets.
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
Pass to Rivers. There's the pick. It's stolen by Jack. And now in transition is Jack. Here we go. Anthony with the defensive effort.
Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Anthony drawing the double team. Rivers against Jack. And it's sent back by Lopez. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez touched it last. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Brooklyn leading by nine. Johnson kicks to Evans. Johnson dishes to Evans. Deflects the pass. Back to Johnson. Here's Lopez up and in on the layup. Lopez has got the lead up to 11 now for the Nets.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Anthony drives in and a missed layup.
And trying to come up with a highlight reel finish, somebody forgot to finish it.
Follow against Evans. Jack passes to Evans. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. It's on Aaron Aflalo.
Shooting for Brooklyn. Free!
The first one falls.
You really have to like their efficiency at the foul line. I mean, they're knocking down 91-92% of their free throws overall. That's a very healthy and positive number.
Knicks trail by 13. Rivers passes to Porzingis. Soft touch off the glass.
Boy, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
For Brooklyn, they've gone 5 of 8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. And Jack kicks to Evans. Lopez with the steal. The drive by Anthony, and it's Brook Lopez with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
The Nets making a switch here. Thornton's checked in. Passes it to Porzingis. Aflalo dishes to Anthony. There's a screen. The pass to Porzingis. Let's it go with a three. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Anthony's got 6 assists here tonight.
How can you forget about him? I mean, he's not going to miss that open of a look.
Jack passes to Evans. Lopez sets a screen for Evans. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path
to the bucket. Mm,
that is how it is done.
Excellent team play there on the pick, and then he ripped it down.
Here's Porzingis, back to Lopez. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. That free throw missing. He hits the second from the line. Nets leading by nine. Now here is Jack. He feeds it to Evans. He takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Threw it down with authority.
Oh, he can really fly. And you combine that, Clark, with some of the nice penetration, too, and you've got an easy 2 points.
And able to just play well above the rim. I mean, that makes this guy so dangerous when he's in the game.
Lopez, a screen on Jack. Porzingis passes to Lopez. Clock at four. They set the screen. Off the pick. They get it back. For Brooklyn, they've gone 7 of 10 shooting the ball since the start of the fourth quarter. Here's Lopez. Again, the Nets for two.
Just the height separation on that mid-range jumper. Excellent job of taking advantage.
And here's Rivers. Pass to Porzingis from 17 feet out. Second chance shot, and it's sent back by Lopez. And he gets it back.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
And the first one drops. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Nets leading by 12. Evans kicks to Johnson. Good. Johnson's got 5 points in the quarter.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Here's Anthony. True on the 14-footer. Anthony's got 14 points now in the second half.
And he's made more than his fair share of those today.
Jack against Rivers. It's stolen by Anthony. And here we go with Anthony running it up the court. Misses from short range.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Lopez, a screen on Anthony. The dish to Thornton. Back to Evans. Nets passing it around. And the dunk by Lopez.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
And guys, it's not the time for caution now. I mean, they've got to be aggressive and take some risk to see if they can cut that lead down.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
Jack with it. Picked up by Rivers. They set the pick. Evans kicks to Lopez. And he gets it to go. Lopez has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
And now we can see them really working it inside.
Yeah, Clark, quality looks at the rim. That's fueling this run.
Lopez sets a screen for Anthony. Lopez, a screen on Johnson. The three-pointer off the mark.
Well, he had one three-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
Here's Evans. In the corner, Thornton with it. Back to Evans. He shoots again, and it's Lopez laying it in. Lopez has got 19 points.
We're seeing him bring that shooting percentage up now, guys. The first half was a struggle for him.
Here's Rivers. Good on the shot.
Austin took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on him.
The Nets on offense. They're on a 14-6 run.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Jack dishes to Evans. Johnson the screen. Evans passes to Johnson. To the middle. And Evans throws it down hard.
Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that dish.
They can't guard us on the perimeter.
Catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Spacing.
Yes, exactly, Kevin. Spacing. I got a chance to hear what Scott Skiles said to his team. He said their plan was run their offense through Evans. Coach is calling on him to play a big role in the offense for the rest of this game, to really be one of the key guys for them down the stretch. He said also that their offense needs to be a patient one. He told them, don't rush things. Use as much of that shot clock as you need to. It's pretty late in the game to be altering the game plan, but they're going to come out with a different look here, guys. Back to you.
All right, Doris, thanks.
It's this simple, guys. No rebounds, no rims. We need to dominate the glass. Bigs, get the ball off the rim and get it out
now
to
Jack.
Our guards. Get out in transition. Got it. Get the ball inside.
Evans up top. Lopez over to help. Evans kicks to Thornton. It's tipped. And it's a follow, penetrating, off on the layup.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in control of this game.
And no doubt about it, rebounding is an effort stat, folks. They've been more determined than their opponent thus far.
Johnson off the pick from Evans.
And that fourth foul, guys, might force him to scale back the aggression from a defensive standpoint. He does not need, nor does the team need, number five.
A minute 42 left in the fourth quarter. And he comes off the screen and slams it through.
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is secure.
I'm almost ready to go there with you, partner. Not quite. I'm hanging around at that 98% mark. So it's just about done, but I need a little more evidence to close the book on it.
They get the rebound. Nets leading by 17.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Nets.
Barkley simply ran them off the court.
It was all about the transition game. Fast break points the difference.
And with this win, they'll end up notching another victory for this year's campaign, win number 33.
And continued dominance against this team, winning both of their matchups this season.
And, you know, against a conference opponent, Greg, who you're going to see four times total on the season, a 2-0 advantage is pretty healthy.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for Evans. He did it all tonight, making an impact with more than just his scoring. How about the fact that he got a triple-double?
He kicks to Lopez. Down low. And it's Evans missing.
That's what we call good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
And it's out of bounds for the Knicks as New York retains possession.
Out of bounds. New York ball. Substitution for the Nets. Tyler Hansbrough.
There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
How about the inbound pass there? Easy bucket.
Austin Rivers.
They're making this a runaway.
And the only question for me right now is just how big the lead will eventually become.
He dishes it to Bogdanović. The basket good off the assist from Evans.
And just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And, Greg, those fans had a hand in the win. I mean, they gave this team a big lift throughout the game. I thought there was great energy in the building.
And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team, Clark, by far tonight.
No question about it, Kevin. They certainly gave their fans plenty to scream and holler about. This place was rocking. It was on fire. And it only got louder as that lead got.
Well, with a game like tonight, you were all over the place. A triple-double in the box score. Would you consider this one of your better games of the season thus far?
A real triple-double? Y'all didn't even know it.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, along with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Let's quickly move forward now. Freak! And another triple-double from him in this game. And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille...
TV, we have the second annual Hey Guys Awards with some amazing prizes for you.
Oh, word? That's what's up.
Plus, a sneak peek at what's to come in 2K17.
You know, the other thing that we get to do next year is...
Tune in now. On today's season finale episode of NBA 2K TV, we have the second annual Hey Guys Awards with some amazing prizes for you.
Oh, word? That's what's up.
Plus, a sneak peek at what's to come in 2K17.
You know, the other thing that we get to do next year is...
Tune in now. On today's season finale episode of NBA 2K TV, we have the second annual Hey Guys Awards with some amazing prizes for you.
Oh, word? That's what's up.
A sneak peek at what's to come in 2K17.
You know, the other thing that we get to do next year is...
Tune in now.